amount to be collected not to exceed $123,690 for the attached documents.
Motion to approve.
Support.
Okay, I have a motion by Councilman Cross, supported by Councilman Remick. Is there any discussion? Not all those in favor say yes.
Yes.
All opposed say no. Motion carries. Item 15 is a motion to approve establishing a 2019 winter special assessment rule for purposes of collecting $235,276 in county drain charges for the attached documents.
Motion. Support.
Okay, I have a motion by Councilwoman Whitten, supported by Councilwoman Croft. Is there any discussion? If not, all those in favor say yes.
Yes.
All opposed say no. Motion carries. Item 16 is a motion to approve establishing a 2019 winter special assessment rule for purposes of collecting streetlight charges in amount not to exceed $1,198,588 per the attached documents.
Motion to approve.
Support.
I have a motion by Councilwoman Cross, supported by Councilman Missouri. Is there any discussion? If not, all those in favor say yes.
Yes.
All opposed say no. Motion carries. Item 17 is a motion to approve establishing a 2019 winter special assessment rule for the collection of false alarm accounts receivable charges for an amount of $13,750 based on the attached documents.
Motion.
Support.
I have a motion by Councilwoman Wynn, supported by Councilman Bazura. Is there any discussion? If not, all those in favor say yes.
Yes.
All opposed say no. Motion carries. Okay, we do have one open business item. This would be open business number one. And this is a motion to approve a settlement for claim number P615-16-00314 as recommended by Risk Management.
Motion to approve.
Support.
Okay, I have a motion by Councilwoman Cross, supported by Councilwoman Whitten. All those in favor say yes.
Yes. Yes.
All opposed say no.
No.
Roll call.
Mr. Johnson?
No.
Mr. Bazura?
No.
Mrs. Pat?
Yes.
Mr. Remick?
Yes.
Mrs. Winton?
Yes.
Ms. Cross?
Yes.
Mr. Woolley?
Yes. Motion carries. Okay, at this time, I'd like to ask the council or the mayor if they have any open business they'd like to discuss tonight.
This Thursday at the library, we're going to have our historical society has George Goode coming in as a speaker. So if anyone would like to come and hear George's history, he has a lot of history, come on out to the library. I believe it's at 6 o'clock on Thursday.
Okay. So, Mayor, I wonder if we could have Mr. Clark come up and explain about Beach Daily, what the projection is on that, and what we're looking forward to in the next week or so.
I actually have a more up-to-date update than I provided you yesterday. There was a conference call with the contractor, MDOT, and our engineers this afternoon. If you went by there today, you can see the contractor was working out there today doing the concrete work. What the plan is they're coming in tomorrow to put the tack coat on the southbound lane, and they're scheduled to come in and put asphalt down on the southbound lane on Thursday, weather permitting. This is all permitted under the weather. So it's looking pretty good. If it rains a little bit, we can still do the asphalt work, but it's raining hard, we'll push it off to the next day. And after the base course is put down, we will remove the barrels, and we're going to open up the lanes to north and southbound traffic, and they will resume construction in the spring.
So basically, they're going to finish up little things, and they're going to remove so both lanes will be open during the winter time.
Yes.
And then in the spring, we will apply that address.
That's correct.
Mr. Chair, I have a question. Can you let the residents know that, you know, we're hearing a lot of things that it's the city that's doing this, and it's our fault because the guys aren't working in that. Who are the contractors and who are actually doing the job?
The contractor that was awarded the project through MDOT it was let, and the contract, the way it works is that there's a contract between the contractor and MDOT, and MDOT and the city. And they administer the contract. You know, we have some say-so, but as far as demanding to come out there, we don't hold any funds where we can withhold them to come out here or have any penalties. Those contracts don't work that way. And that's basically where we're at with that as far as the authority to make them come out here to do it. All we can do is say, you know, we're not going to give you a very good reference if you try to use this for a reference.
Councilman Johnson?
So, am I correct from what I heard last night from the mayor that MDOT delayed or was late getting the contract signed on board?
That's correct. So, about 2.5
weeks behind?
About 2.5 weeks. As I explained last night, I signed it, the bid was let, I signed the letter to proceed on September 30th. We had our pre-construction meeting with the contractor, MDOT, October 1st, and the contractor is ready to proceed immediately, like in the 2 days, I think, on Wednesday. And when they didn't come show up, we found out that, you know, MDOT didn't award the contract as of yet. And it took them, I believe, 2.5 weeks after that meeting to award the contract.
So it would be safe to say that we wouldn't even be in this spot if MDOT did the job. Pretty much. I mean, 2.5 weeks.
It had been close to finish up. We probably would have it open. Yeah. The base course would probably have been put on, but the wearing course might not have been put on. I don't know.
Of course, 10 inches of snow.
Excuse me?
Of course, 10 inches of snow.
Yeah, the snow too. And the rain.
Mr. Chair, one more question. I had asked a comment last night, but a question last night in regards to any violations, ordinance violations to any of those people that live along Beach Daily. You responded that there were none.
No, I'm not aware of any ordinance violations provided. I don't know why we write any ordinance violations.
Well, that was my question.
Yeah.
If we did. If there is any out there in residence and, you know, can come to us and say, hey, this is when it happened, this is what they gave it to me for, but you would have a record of all those ordinances anyways, correct?
Mr. Chairman, if I may, I just want to make sure, we would not write ordinances that were caused or created by the construction. However, residents still have an obligation to do their part. I mean, it doesn't necessarily just give them a free pass because construction's going on. I just want to make sure, because I don't want people to leave here thinking that, you know, ordinances don't apply while the construction's happening.
Well, I'm thinking of like the GFL, the, you know, the trash being out there, or, you know, your car not being able to park wherever, those kinds of things. I'm not talking about anything else other than that.
Anything related to, Mr. Chairman, anything related to the construction causing it, for sure.
And the traffic stops.
No comment. Thank you, Mr. Bach.
Yes, sir.
Real quick, I got something to say. You can go ahead. Oh, I thought you were going to say no. I see a familiar face out in the crowd. And I just want to point him out because he's done a lot of volunteer things in the city. He's taken pictures at concerts. And I consider him a friend. And he's going through one heck of a battle. I just want to know that you have my support 100%, my friendship. And I wish you nothing but the best in your battle.
Thank you.
Thank you. Mayor?
I echo that sentiment. And I would also add that we need you to get well soon because we got a summer concert coming up. And need you to be there, you know, with your heavy metal attitude and your camera.
Mr. Chair, can the Mrs. Barkin speak on the Goodfellas? Any updates?